Hi everyone, this is a continuation of your lecture related to the working of a three-phase half-way coil rectifier with resistive load. Now we will have our concentration on two things. One is where the firing angle alpha less than 30 degrees, the other case is firing angle greater than 30 degrees. For firing angle less than 30 degrees, we have seen that the thyristor is going to conduct from, let it be thyristor T1, it will be conducting from omega T is equal to 30 plus alpha to 150 plus alpha. So if alpha is 0 degrees, it will be conducting from 30 to 150. That we can clearly see it from this particular instant. Now just imagine that your alpha is, so this is for alpha equal to 0 degrees. Now we can imagine that alpha is 30 degrees. So it will be from 60 to 180 degrees. So that is, that will be from this particular instant to this particular instant, it will be conducting. So this was actually, it is for 15 degrees. And it was conducting from alpha equal to 15 degrees, that is from 45 degrees to 150 plus 15, that is 165 degrees it was conducting. So here the total conducting period of the thyristor is nothing but 120 degrees, which is clearly visible from these values. So again here your thyristor T2, if you are considering, it will be conducting from 150 plus alpha to 270 plus alpha. So that is, this is nothing but the 150 and this is nothing but 270. So maximum it can perform 150 plus alpha to 270 plus alpha. So at any instances, the degree of conduction will be always 120 degrees. Now we will see it for alpha greater than 30 degrees. So here you can see that the thyristor will be stop conducting at this instant, which is equal to 180 degrees. So for any angle alpha greater than 30 degrees, the period of conduction will be from omega t equal to 30 plus alpha to 180 degrees, where this alpha, it is basically, we have taken it as greater than 30 degrees. So effectively you can say that the period through which a single thyristor will be conducting is only 150 minus alpha. So that we can again clearly see it from this particular diagram which we have drawn it for alpha equal to 60 degrees. So it is 150 minus 60. 150 minus 60 is nothing but 90 degrees. So that we can see it, the period of conduction here, it is from 90 to 180 degrees. So effectively we can say that for a resistive load, the maximum value of the firing angle possible is 150 degrees. There is a maximum possible firing angle which is possible with a resistive load. Now we will be finding the average load voltage for a continuous conduction mode. That is, your alpha is between 0 less than alpha less than 30 degrees. So therefore the average output voltage VDC is nothing but, so you can see that the period of conduction is 2 pi by 3. That is 120 degrees. So therefore you can say it is 1 divided by 2 pi by 3, and we have already seen that the thyristor will be conducting from alpha plus 30 to maximum to alpha plus 150. So your omega t will be varying from alpha plus 30 to alpha plus 150. That is, this is 30 and this is 150. And it is Vm sin omega t. So this you can derive the equation and you will be getting your answer as 3 root 3 divided by 2 pi into Vm cos alpha. In a similar way, you also need to find out the average output voltage V naught RMS, which you need to find it by yourself. Now we are going to derive the average load voltage and the RMS voltage for a discontinuous conduction, that is your firing angle alpha greater than 30 degrees. And we have already seen that the maximum value at which you can fire your thyristor for a resistive load is 150 degrees. So it is from 30 to 150 degrees you can consider. So the average load voltage V naught is nothing but 1 by 2 pi by 3, 2 pi by 3 because 2 pi by 3 is the single pulse duration period, and then we are going to fire my thyristor. It is from alpha plus 30, so that is at this instant after 30 degrees. Any instant you can take, and then the maximum value is 180 degrees, which is we all have already made the conclusion. It can go up till 180 degrees. So it is up to 180 degrees Vm sin omega t d omega t. So from here you will be getting your answer, it as 3 Vm by 2 pi into 1 plus cos alpha plus 30. So derivation you have to do in the similar way. You also need to find out the V naught RMS. So that is how the total explanation of a three-phase half-way control rectifier with resistive load comes into picture. So again, repeating with respect to the limits which you have taken it over here, for the discontinuous conduction mode it is alpha plus 30 degrees. 30 is nothing but the value at which I can fire my thyristor, and this value of alpha is nothing but which is always greater than 30 degrees, and that is which is showing this particular instance. And then it can go up till conduction up to 180 degrees, because after 180 degrees the thyristor goes into the reverse bias mode and therefore it will get commutated. So that is the maximum limit is 180 degrees. But in the case of a continuous conduction mode, we have already seen that in the thyristor it will be, for alpha equal to 0, it will be conducting from 30 to 150. That is omega t is from 30 to 150. So if alpha is between 0 and 30 degrees, then it will be from 30 plus alpha to 150 plus alpha. So that is how it is for the continuous conduction mode.